Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Automotive, here today with a video on the most common Subaru EJ255 engine problems. The EJ255 turbocharged flat 4 engine was introduced in 2004 and remained in production through 2014. It's most notably found in the Subaru WRX and offers up to 265 horsepower from the factory, so ultimately the EJ255 offers a good overall balance of performance, reliability, and efficiency. However, no engine is perfect, and that applies to the EJ255 as well. Unfortunately, the EJ255, while I did mention it is a relatively reliable engine, does have a few potentially serious and catastrophic engine problems. So with that said, let's go ahead and jump in and discuss some of the most common problems with the Subaru EJ255. Starting with number one on the list here, I lumped a few things together and am just considering this internal engine problems as being one of the more common issues with the EJ255 engine. One thing to mention before I actually dive into these internal issues is that these problems are a lot less common on a completely stock, unmodified EJ255. However, these engines are popular to tune and modify, and ultimately, when you do start modding these engines, the EJ255 does have a few internal faults that become more prevalent and much more likely when you are throwing more power at the engine. So when modding the EJ255, a couple of the major weak points are the piston rings, or specifically the ringlands, and then also the rod bearings. So I don't want to get too far into the specifics on these internal engine problems. There's tons of information out there. Anyone familiar with the EJ255 or very involved in the Subaru community is likely already well aware of these issues. Just something I wanted to point out for anyone looking to get into the EJ255 without any knowledge of these. But again, nothing to hold against the EJ255 that much, at least in stock form. Moving on to the second most common issue, we have turbocharger failure. Now, there are a couple things to unpack here when it comes to turbo failure. There was actually a design flaw with the banjo bolt over time getting gunked up and really reducing oil flow to the turbocharger, and that could in turn cause premature turbo failure. So it's very important to pay attention to that banjo bolt, stay on top of oil changes. Just doing that and cleaning the banjo bolt can keep that stock turbo safe and healthy. A couple other things to talk about with turbo failure. Again, as I mentioned briefly in the last section talking about internal problems, we are talking about what's now a decade plus old engine. While modern turbos are very capable and tend to last near the lifetime of the engine, it's still not uncommon to just have normal wear and tear failures, especially as these turbos get up to 125, 150,000 plus miles. And then another consideration, not only with the age, but just with turbocharger failures and when turbos tend to start failing, is that again, the EJ255 is a very common engine and platform to modify. So if you're picking one up used, even if it's not tuned right now, who knows if it could have been tuned in the past, if it could have been running significantly more than stock boost and still has the original turbocharger. Ultimately, modifying the engine and throwing more boost at the turbo is going to reduce the lifespan of that factory turbocharger. Moving on to our third and final common problem for the Subaru EJ255 engine, we have valve cover gasket oil leaks. There isn't really a true design flaw or issue with the valve cover gaskets, so much as I chose this one as being one of the more common oil leaks on the EJ255, and something to point out and consider with not just this engine, but really any older engine, is a lot of rubber or rubber-like components, things like seals, gaskets, O-rings, etc., tend to degrade with age just as much as they do with mileage. So especially nowadays with how much age and mileage can be on the EJ255, it's not uncommon to start running into some normal wear and tear items like gaskets, seals, O-rings. And among those oil leaks or potential leaks that develop, the valve cover gaskets are common. Since the EJ255 is a flat 4 engine, you do have two valve covers and therefore two valve cover gaskets, which essentially just gives you more opportunity from an oil leak from one or the other. But again, the main point here isn't just to focus on those valve cover gasket oil leaks. The bigger picture is that we are talking about, again, a roughly 10 to 20 year old engine. Components like like these are just going to go bad, and that can be said about any car, any internal combustion engine, and it's something to be aware of in buying an older vehicle. So in summary, briefly talking about overall EJ255 reliability, the EJ255 isn't a completely disastrous, unreliable engine. In fact, it really doesn't have a lot of design flaws or really significant problems in stock form. The main drawback to the EJ255 is that it really doesn't handle modifications and tuning all that well, especially if you're just running standard off-the-shelf tunes. It's very important to go the custom tuning route, make sure you have everything dialed in well, and potentially consider addressing some things up front like the rods, rod bearings, pistons, etc. All great stuff to do, because that's really the main drawback of the EJ255. Outside of that, the only other really major consideration is that, as I mentioned a few times, we are talking about a slightly older engine nowadays, so things like oil leaks, coolant leaks, and some gasket seals, hoses, O-rings going bad are going to be normal for the EJ255. That's not fair to only say about this Subaru engine, but really any car and internal combustion engine in general. So point being, the EJ255 can be a very reliable engine, but a lot of them are modified and tuned over the years, and that can be a major drawback to the reliability of this engine. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for more in the future. Thanks, everyone.